Whether you're in production or development, Application Insights offers a set of services to help you monitor your application for availability, performance, and usage. In this video, we're going to take a look at setting up customer usage. So as you see, I've actually got Visual Studio Online, and I've got a brand new option for trying Application Insights. Opening that up, I have a, depending on if I've used it or not, either a getting started experience or my dashboards. In this case, I can go ahead and take a look at that customer usage that I'm going to show you how to get started, kind of as a teaser of what you're going to get. You can see the number of active users. I can see the number of sessions. If I want to take a look at the environment, I can see what operating systems, what browsers. I can take a look at the geography. I can even, as a developer, put out custom events, what buttons were pressed, what activities me as a developer are interested in doing. Now, in this case, I want to show you how to set it up for your application. Pressing the Add Application, I'm giving a set of options. At this point, I can go ahead and collect the data from either a server component or not a server component. In this case, since we want to take a look at the customer usage, we're going to choose No. Now I'm giving an option of looking at a website or monitoring a website or Windows Phone 8. Click on the Windows Phone 8. It's asking me what application, and I could call it WP for Windows Phone. And at this point, it is going ahead and giving us the directions. So here it's giving me the NuGet package I need to actually add, giving me the directions. I'm going to walk through setting this up for a website. Once again, it's asking me what website. And either I can create this one, or actually, let's do a different one. So I'm going to say usage website. Let's spell that right. And this is giving me a block of JavaScript code that I need to input or add to my application. I'm going to go ahead and start Visual Studio and go out and do a new website. And we're going to do a ASP.NET WebForms website. We'll call this one usage AI1. Now, since this is a WebForms application, it uses the paradigm of using master sheets. And I'm going to go ahead and open the site master. And going to the head, I'm going to import that JavaScript, or add the JavaScript. At this point, saving this and running the application is all I need to do. This is going to show me all of that information. How many users, what pages, how fast did the pages load, what geographies. I didn't show you the geographies, but I can actually get information as to what areas in the world they're coming from. Countries, states, etc. And if I generate some traffic, we can go back in and actually see that traffic. Now in this case, the traffic's going to take about 15 minutes to load. So you're going to need to wait. I'm going to go ahead and pause the video, and in about 15 minutes we're going to come back in and actually show you that application data that we just ran from clicking on these. So again, what we're going to see is we're going to see traffic from IE clicking on three or four pages. Actually, let's go ahead and copy that and start up Chrome. And once again, we'll just generate some traffic here. If I wanted to actually do application performance monitoring, I'd probably throw an exception or do other things that I could see the performance and how it actually involves the internals of my code. But in this case, all I want to see is what is the user doing. So hang on 1 second, and we'll be right back. All right, so we're back. I waited about 15, maybe a little bit longer minutes, and you can see that the data is just now starting to come in. You can see that I've actually looked at some different traffic. I've got the duration of that traffic. I can take a look at some of the features, get an idea of what pages did I click on, drill down through what time was it, and again all these little thumbtacks, or if I want to add it to that thumb to my dashboard. Taking a look at the performance, I can get an idea of